going on, everybody? Benny Bassett here for another June cover tune. If you're not familiar with me, my music, or what I've been up to this month, it is African American Music Appreciation Month during the month of June, every June. And I decided, with all that's going on in the world, with all the protesting going on, that there's so many voices out there that it's kind of clouding the message, and I decided I should stick to my industry, to music, and play songs that that I think and that the world thinks are some of the most influential, important songs that were written, sung, performed, composed, produced by African Americans in American music history. So this is video 14, I think. And the last few days I've found myself saying, this is a big one. This is a very important artist because so Motown had so many hit artists, innovative artists. They defined a whole era, a whole sound, an entire new genre of music that came out of Motown, and Stevie Wonder is no different. He was signed to Motown when he was 11. He was blind since birth, and he just had a vision and an ear for unique sounds, different sounds, instruments being used in different ways. He signed to this to Motown. Tamla was the imprint of the record label at 11, and he and his mom go on tour. They get a stipend every week from the record label. The record label hires Little Stevie Wonder, as he was known at the time, a private tutor so that he can continue to learn while he was on the road. And the contract agreed to give him all, you know, his rights and royalties when he was 21. So time goes on. He kind of makes some music. Nothing really takes off. He's still very young. And he ends up getting married at 20. And his wife and he decide to kind of change the kind of where his music comes from. He wants to get more involved in social issues, wants his lyrics to be deeper and more meaningful. And there was a lot of, you know, doo-wop love song type thing going on with Motown at the time, and I think Stevie wanted to take it to another level. And it wasn't received real well right away, but he turned 21, renegotiated his contract with Motown. It was a 120-page contract. It was groundbreaking for the industry. It gave Stevie production control over his music, which means he, you know, made all the calls on who to hire, what it sound like, levels, mixing, all that kind of stuff, engineering. And he also got more royalties, which was kind of unheard of at the time. So not only an innovative, groundbreaking musician, but also a fighter for musicians' rights and composers' rights and production rights. On top of all that, he ends up writing his first couple records, just his first three records go through the roof. He's the first, only artist to ever win three Album of the Year awards for three records in a row. All he did was make hits. they even named this period during the 70s his classic period, where he just, everything he made turned to gold. And this, the song I'm going to do today, was the very first song that he had entire, complete control over, production-wise. And so that's why I chose to do it today. He's won 20-something Grammy Awards. I could have chosen one of many of his songs, but this one, his first full control song, and he put sitar on it. Just to give you an idea, that's not Motown. In case we're all getting educated here together, sitar didn't come from Detroit. Just throwing it out there. But anyway, just one of the most awarded musicians of all time, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Songwriter Hall of Fame, and he's even more importantly to this video series and to why I'm doing this, he was a huge, huge part of the Civil Rights Movement. He fought for Martin Luther King's birthday to be a national holiday. He's received the United Nations a Messenger of Peace, Ambassador of Peace. I should probably know the title. But he received an award from the United Nations for his peacekeeping work, peacekeeping efforts. And he has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. He's been in movies. He's been hosted in the White House. He is just simply one of the most, once in a generation kind of talents. And so I'm going to try and cover one of his songs because Why not? But that's what I'm up to. It's a way that I've chosen to honor African Americans in my industry and to not give them a voice, but to amplify their voice, because they've certainly done plenty themselves. But it's my way of honoring them, of honoring the folks that are out there fighting for equality and justice and protesting. Send my love to you guys and hope you're staying safe out there. But this was, like I said, Stevie Wonder's first full production control tune that he wrote and produced. So here we go. Let's make some magic. Like a fool, I went stayed too long. Now I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. In that time I went said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Done a lot of foolish things that I really didn't mean, yeah. Seen a lot of things in this old world. When I touched them, they did nothing, girl. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Ooh, we baby set my soul on fire. That's why I know you're my only desire. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Done a lot of foolish things that I really, I didn't mean. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. That's Stevie Wonder with the Benny Bassett Computer Backing Band. I had to do Stevie a little justice and add some flavor to the song today, so hope you enjoyed it. Again, we're here because it's African American Music History Month. We're here because there are people out there still being oppressed, a whole group of people being oppressed, being murdered, and it's just crazy that this is still happening right now. So, sending all love out to you. Hopefully this is providing some goodness in the world right now, and I've been happy to learn more about these artists that have influenced me and my friends and the other musicians out there, and to learn where our music history has come from and been, and what it's taught us about where we are today. So hope you guys are enjoying these. Hope you have been following along with the series. There's a Spotify playlist where you can hear the original recordings by Stevie and the rest of the artists I've covered. Ray Charles, Billie Holiday, Robert Johnson. There's a ton of them. But there will be more coming. One a day in June. And, yeah, we'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.